My name is AJIMOKO, and I'm an entrepreneur. It's so difficult to come up to speak after all the great speakers we have had here today. So I want you all to put your hands together for the wonderful speakers we have had so far. All right. So about 2 weeks or 3 weeks ago, I got a call from Dr. Ashraf, and he told me I'll be one of the speakers that will be speaking today. The first thing that came to my mind was, what am I going to be speaking about? But as we progressed in the conversation, I remember he mentioned that the theme of this event is going to be deliberate conversations. So I said, if that's the case, then let's have deliberate conversations about startups and startup owners. All right. So according to the World Bank, Nigeria is presently out of recession, and the economy is growing at the rate of 2% per annum. Okay? Now, the economists say that's a good one, and we are all supposed to be happy. But when I ask Nigerians on the streets of Lagos, in Port Harcourt, in Kano, in Lokoja, in Abuja, there is no time that Nigerians are pressed to creating additional streams of income like the time that we are in now. So because of that, On a daily basis, new businesses are born and new entrepreneurs are created out of panic and out of fear of the unknown. Now, there's a study by Small Business Association in the USA that says 30% of businesses that are created every year fold up after about 2 years of creation. They go on to give statistics that about 30% goes up before the third year, then 50% are likely to fail before their fifth year. Now, trust me, these statistics are far higher in Nigeria, but unfortunately, we don't have statistics. But I can tell you that the data is much higher in Nigeria. So, if you're a small business owner that is planning not just to survive the hard time that we are in now, but also to grow a successful business, you need to begin to focus on the important things in your business. And that's why I've come to talk to you today. There's also a quote around I found online that buttresses this point. And it says, ignore the hype of the startups that you see in the press. Mostly, it's a pack of lies. Half of these startups will be dead in a year. So focus on building your business so you can be the one left standing. All right. Now, unfortunately, successful Nigerian people or Nigerian businesses, business owners, rarely write books. So most times when you buy that great business book written by a foreign author, it does not take into cognizance the common problems or the peculiar challenges that we face as Nigerians. Problems like lack of electricity, lack of potable water, lack of security, lack of credit lines or credit facilities. You know, the list goes on and on and on. But today, I'd like to share with you three very simple things that I learned from growing my business from nothing to where we are today. These are lessons that you don't learn in your MBA classes, and you can't be taught in your professional certificate programs. They are things that I learned from bootstrapping my way to where we are today. All right. So let's jump into it. The first thing is what I call avoiding the CEO craze. Hashtag humble yourself. The time we are now, it's a very difficult time, okay? Thank you. So, why do you need to avoid the CEO craze? First of all, you need to understand what that means. Back in my undergraduate days in university, I had a team of very ambitious friends. So, we planned to start big in life, you know, be the boss, be the next big thing, you know, and all that. So, people can relate to that. And every weekend, we used to attend motivational seminars in schools. So, and the motivational speakers come and they tell you things like, you know, you are born to be great, you know, you can be your own boss, everybody's born to be a winner, you know, you can be the next big thing, and so on and so forth. So you come out, your head is swelling, you believe, yes, it's time. So the first thing you do is to call your graphic designer pal and say, guy, you need to design that business card for me. My name on top, CEO. Under. Please, it's a trap. Don't fall for it. Don't do it. Not just yet. It's not time yet. Okay? Remember the key word in my presentation is focus. So at that point, you don't want to talk about being a CEO for the following reasons. One, the customer measures or values the worth and the value of your business based on the value and the worth of the CEO. That's the truth of the matter. So when you meet a customer, the customer will judge you by your presentation, your appearance, your exposure, your experience, and your confidence. And most times they conclude on the value of your business. So at that time where you're not ready to be a CEO but you're carrying the label, most times they are not coming through properly to the customer. Because at that point in your business, you don't have all these ingredients in the proper mix. The second point, or the second reason why you should avoid this, is as the CEO, there is no room for deflection because the buck stops at your table. You call the shot, you are the boss, so no one else will ask the question. So when you prepare for those business meetings or your marketing presentations, most times there's always one question or something you don't envisage that you leave out. And then you meet with the customer, you interface with the customer, you're making your presentation. Trust me, that question will come. And then you're not prepared, you're not ready. The customer is likely to judge you unready or sometimes unqualified for their money or the business. Three now. Customers forgive bigger businesses. I will explain that with a story. Some time ago, I closed from work and I was leaving the office. I was in the company of my friend, Vivian. She's sitting here. And as we left the office, I stopped on the roadside to buy oranges. So I gave the orange seller 100 naira, and he gave me 4 oranges. Immediately, my friend reminded him, said, no, I'm supposed to give you 5. Why is he giving you 4? An argument ensued, and she won. We got 5 oranges for 100 naira, thanks to my friend. All right, fast forward to like a week after. My friend, Vivian, bought credit on her phone and subscribed for data, 2,500 naira. And the data usually lasts her for a month. But mysteriously, after 2 days, the data vanished from her phone. You would think my freedom fighter was going to pull down the telecom company, right? But lo and behold, all she did was she went back, bought data, and subscribed again. Forgave the telecoms company. The same person did not forgive my orange seller because of one orange. But she let go the telecoms company that took 2,500 naira from her. That's what your customers do to you when they know that they are bigger than you. That's what you do to your tailor. That's what you do to your mechanic. That's what you do to your dry cleaner. That's what you do to your driver. Because you feel you are bigger than your driver. You're bigger than your mechanic. You're bigger than these business owners. So when the customer perceives, after valuing you, that I'm bigger than this whole business, this whole guy, they have some sense of authority that he can demand anything out of you, okay? So it's one of the reasons why you should avoid the CEO praise. Yes, another point is that being the CEO or wanting to be the CEO in your business puts a spending pressure, what I call spending pressure, on your profit. So at a very early stage, you start spending your profit instead of reinvesting it into your business. You start spending your profit because you want to acquire the look and feel of the CEO. You want to buy the right type of wristwatch that fits the CEO. You want to drive the right type of car that fits the CEO. Your shoes, your clothes has to depict that, you know. You are a CEO, you are the boss, isn't it? All right. So this is one of the things that happen when you acquire the CEO title. All right. The fifth part is that really nobody cares who the CEO is. And I would explain that with a story. About a month ago, I had an experience in my house. I used a prepaid meter, and I ran out of credit. It was a weekend, a Saturday. So it was at night also. So there was no place to go buy, you know, or pay for credit. So the whole house was dark. And I just I felt there should be a way out. So on my phone, I Googled how to buy power credits in Nigeria. And there was a list of sites, and I chose the first one. I entered my card details, blah, blah, I kept on. You know, I got a token, I entered into meter, and light came back up. Now, am I a happy customer? Yes. Did I recommend that business to other friends? Yes. Did I use it again? Yes. Do I know who the CEO is? No. Do I care who the CEO is? No. So nobody cares who the boss is, man. Nobody cares. Just do the damn job you have promised your customers you're going to do. Focus on delivering your promise to your customer, not on being the boss, not on your tie, not on your shoes, not on your looks, but on the value your business is supposed to deliver. All right. You see, it might look very simple, but sometimes you don't understand the power that title wields. It's just a title. And believe me, it doesn't add anything to your bottom line. It doesn't add anything to the money that comes in, either you're the boss or not. It doesn't. But if I decide to stage a play here now, and I bring up three people on stage, and I said, you be the CEO, you be the PA, you be the driver, even in your minds, there's an expectation of that CEO. You expect him to be the one giving out the orders. You expect him to be the one calling the shot, just because he's not a CEO, just because I called him a CEO on stage. You expect that if he's going to act that role properly, then he should be the one calling the shot. That's what the title does to you. So it takes a lot of energy away from your business. I put it on you, just trying to be someone that I don't know if you want to be or not. Remember that at this point of the life of your business is more important, and focus is the key word. All right. So, are we good? Okay. Until this begins to cooperate, all right. The second point is very important to me, and I call it managing relationships, okay? Hashtag, your village people move to town. Yeah. For any business to succeed, relationship is very, very important. It's so important that the big corporations, the banks, the telecoms companies, these days have what they call relationship officers, okay? And the job of relationship officers is to bond with the customer and ensure customer loyalty or repeat patronage. All right. Now, if your business is going to succeed, you need to pay attention to your relationships. As a small business owner or a new entrepreneur or a new startup owner, you're going to have a lot of relationships. Relationships with your customer, relationship with your supplier, relationship with your creditors, and so on and so forth. All from relationship with your staff and all that and all that. But the most important relationship that I want to talk to you about today is the relationship with your family and friends. Because you are a new startup that nobody knows, okay? The tendency is there for you to approach your customer, your family and friends. They're like your first line of customers, your creditors, or whatever it is you need. If the relationship is not properly managed, your business can die a quick death. So manage the relationship between you and your friends and families very properly, very carefully. And the reason is this. One, friends and families, they like to buy on credit. Hello? Do I have a witness in the house? It's like we share common friends. Good. Friends and families like to buy on credit. When they are broke, they remember you. You know, you are the one to buy from, okay? Number two, they like to pay in installment, even if they will pay. You know, you can't rush me, guy, you understand? You need to understand that. No, we have not been paid. You know, I'm just doing this to encourage you, okay? So, you two need to understand. So, I'll pay in installments. Now, the interesting thing is that even when you have a payment plan for your customers, I remember sometime we were selling some landed properties in Lagos. So, we had payment plans. You drop this money for the first month. You know, the next month, you keep paying like that for like 12 months. Friends and families will come with a special payment plan that they want to, you know, they want to lord over, they want to force you to, listen, guy, no, me, I cannot, you have to spread this thing for me. So instead of 1 year, they want to pay for 2 years, they want to pay for 3 years, you know, and so on and so forth. Then another thing about friends and family is that they usually like to buy at the actual price. The actual price, man, listen, I knew how much they sell that thing in Lagos. So I know where you bought this thing. I'm just trying to encourage. This thing is too expensive. Bring it down. You know, that's what you get with friends and families, okay? So because of time, I'd like to rush to the top point, which is my advice for you. Stay hungry. It's very important as a new business owner, as a young entrepreneur, or a new startup owner, to stay hungry. One of the problems we have in Nigeria is complacence. The moment you start your business and start making some money, people begin to feel complacent, and then begin to forget what brought you into the business. If your business is going to survive the times that we are in now, you need to stay hungry for these following reasons. If you lose your hunger, you lose your sense of creativity. You lose your passion for the business. If you lose your hunger, why did you start? If you lose that, the reason why you got into the business in the first place, if it's because of hunger, and now you are getting fed, you are getting your 3 square meal, there's a tendency for you to begin to forget where you're coming from. And so if you lose your hunger, you lose your ability to innovate, your ability to create more solutions, because your passion is no more there. You also lose your ability to stay relevant. In most cases, you see new businesses begin to come and then begin to overtake, even if you're the first in that business, because you have lost your relevance, okay? Lastly, you also lose your connection to your customer, because you are no longer listening. You are really not interested in what is happening, as long as you're making money. I see a lot of shop owners where I grew up. I go there, they are still the same, the way they were, you know, many years while I was still growing up, because they actually lost their hunger, they lost their passion, and you know, they couldn't create, they couldn't innovate. Lastly, I would like to round off with this quote that I stumbled upon days ago. He said, don't get distracted. Never tell yourself that you need to be the biggest in the world. Start by working on what you need at the present moment, and then what you need to do tomorrow. So set yourself manageable targets by Jazz Bagwinski. That's a co-founder of Heave Sleep. So thank you very much for your time. I appreciate it.